Hong Kong quiets wobbles the good
tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Shut up.
I knew that a lot of friends of mine, some of my so-called friends, had been using Perrier, and they'd been trying to get me into it, and they were always saying things to me like, have a Perrier, or how about a Perrier and lime, and they were just always trying to get me into it, and there was like a lot of peer group pressure, I guess, and then one day, I was just at a party, you know, and I was talking to this guy, and he said to me, can I get you Perrier or something? And I said, yeah, okay. I mean, I figured I could handle it, you know, and I guess that's what everybody thinks. And then before I knew it, I was up to like, oh, about 6 glasses of Perrier, you know, bottles a day. And then, like, the first thing that I would do in the morning, you know, would be like light a cigarette and have a Perrier. So then I just sort of started naturally getting into salads, and it was, you know, like mung beans and tofu, you know, I mean, the whole sick organic trip, you know what I'm saying? And, like, I didn't really think that, like, my lifestyle was really affected or anything. And then this friend of mine comes over, and she said to me, hey, let's jog. And, I mean, I guess that my lifestyle or my head was something was really messed up, well, with all the salads and everything and Perrier. And so I just said, yeah, okay, fine, let's jog. So I'm like, I'm doing like about 5 miles a day, you know. And I just said, turned around and said, 10. Why not 10, you know? I mean, why not, you know? And I mean, do you know what I'm talking about? I'm talking about sweatsuits. I'm talking about headbands. I'm talking about a lot of very expensive running shoes. And in fact, the ones that I like the best are those little Nike Road Runners, you know, the ones that look like little sports cars? Yeah. And then there was like all these subscriptions to the magazines, too, that I had to get to, you know, New York, New West, New Times, High Times, Outside, Apartment Life. And I'm living in...
The world's weekly wait is over. Like magic, an invisible chain of sound once more circles the planet. The National Lampoon Radio Hour is ready again to girdle the globe with giggles.
This is London standing by. Come in, please, National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Mit den Verstolzen erheiben das Berlinen. Wir warten auf Geschweibieten, Sazonke Kachauben, bei Schleunfein Kräben der National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Moskau. Did it those movies in National Lampoon Radio Hour?
Le campagne du Paris. La fer protège belle du National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Come in, please, National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Once again, hello world.
This is Calcutta standing by. Please, now to come in, National Lampoon Radio Hour.
This is Los Angeles, California standing by.
Come in, please, National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Our worldwide network is ready, and here in New York City, the cast and crew of the National Lampoon Radio Hour are in their places. The orchestra leader has raised his baton. So, Mr. Engineer, will you pull the master switch?
Oh, no, not again.
And now, the number one laugh riot of the new television season, the award-winning Dick and Jane Show.
Oh, Dick.
Oh, Jane. See spot.
Uh-oh.
See, spot, run.
Be sure and tune in next week and see, spot, run.
Hello, I'm Fred Perdue, and my chickens eat better than you do. For one thing, I don't let them eat chicken. And if any one of my employees forgets to put my name on a single chicken leg, I chop the stupid bugger up and feed him to the chickens. It takes a tough man to make a tender chick.
This is a public disservice message from the National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Don't use zip codes when you mail.
Instead of helping harried postal clerks, this complicated numbering system may well confuse them, and your letter will either arrive late or else never get there at all.
This is Harry Block with yet another of my 417 reasons why you should let us do your income tax. Reason number 323. We do not allow hordes of killer bees on our premises. These deadly insects could set upon and kill one of our highly trained consultants before he or she even had a chance to save you money on your income taxes. I'll be right back with additional reasons after this important message.
Here's Dr. Chevy Chase with this simple test.
How can I really know if I'm a humorous person or an average run-of-the-mill I-don't-get-it type? Well, it's often better to find out if you're funny in the privacy of your own home first. Right now, unplug your radio and take it into the bathroom with you. We'll give you 5 seconds to get there. Are you there? Good. Plug the radio in and stand in front of your bathroom mirror. Don't be embarrassed. You're all alone. Simply follow instructions. Now, insert the pinky fingers of your left and right hands, respectively, into the left and right corners of your mouth, like so. Pull hard so that your lips peel back and you can see your teeth. Are you looking at yourself in the mirror? Is it funny? You've probably started chuckling already, haven't you? A good sign. Let's hurry while we have the moment and move right on to the shtick test. Okay, now, still keeping one finger in your mouth, take your other hand and remove the top from the jar of Vaseline on the shelf below your mirror. Ordinary toothpaste or shaving cream will do. Spread some on your left cheek and in your hair. Pretty funny, huh? If you're not already laughing, try drooling or spitting up on yourself a bit and wiping it into your shirt. The shoulder is always a funny place to do this. While you are laughing, immediately remove the other finger from your mouth and change instantly into a serious expression. And, while looking right into your reflection, say the words moose poop or poupée. You're sure to crack yourself up. Here comes the final and most important test to help you find out if you indeed have a sense of humor. Open the cabinet and remove the blade from your razor. Close the cabinet and stare at your face briefly. No smiling or cracking up. Now, quickly, just as fast as you can, slit your left wrist, taking care not to cut the tendons. Only the blood vessels should be severed. Repeat with your right wrist. Okay? Now, if you thought I was serious about slitting your wrists, you blew it. And clearly you don't have a sense of humor at all. If, however, you thought I was only kidding, you're right.
This is Harry Block with yet another of my 417 reasons why you should let us do your income tax. Reason number 110. Many on our staff are Jewish, if you see what I'm getting at. I'll be right back with additional reasons after this important message.
Good evening. Welcome once again to our program. We are very privileged to have with us in this studio today the 19-year-old perfect master from Champaign-Urbana, Mr. Craig Baker, and he is with us right here.
Listen, Barry Gita, I just want to say right now before we start, you know, that last time I was here, you know, I was real drunk, you know.
Right.
I was blasted.
Blasted, you were, yes.
So I just want to say I apologize for getting so drunk and,
oh, that's okay.
You know, calling you a wog and everything and throwing up on you and calling you towel head and
that's
stuff,
all right.
You know.
That's okay.
But, you know, I was drunk, you know, and
I'm sorry
everybody out there, you know.
Well, that's a Mr. Baker, Mr.
And I got a present for you, too. Somebody tell you how I feel about you.
That is so nice.
Here it is. This is a first pre-mixed, pre-measured disposable douche for you.
Oh, goodness gracious me.
That's right.
Merci,
doctor. That's how I feel about you.
I smell good.
Yeah.
I like that very much. Yes, my wife, Peter,
really?
Will enjoy
You're my
this.
Only douchebag friend.
Well... That is very nice gift. What a nice wrapper.
Listen, I'm real sorry, so I apologize.
Let me say to you, as hands across the sea, I forgive you. I forgive you by the sons of Gilgamesh, and I forgive you in all the ways of narrow streets and avenue. I review any star upon you shall be good from now on.
Okay.
And you are my close friend, bosom buddy.
All right, let's just drop it, okay, Hosejab? Let's just drop it. Mm. I apologize.
And I just think that it's so forgiving of me to forgive you in this manner that I'm happy, enjoy myself and my God.
You got any beer?
I don't have beer, no, I don't.
Oh, come on, you Hosejab, don't you have any beer?
I don't have beer, but I do have a question for you.
What?
Mr. 19, your perfect master. Yeah. Do you have a miracle to perform for us today?
I do have a miracle, yes.
Tell me
I do.
What it is.
We are going to transform ourselves right into a bar.
Goodness me, no.
A bar.
I cannot believe it.
We're going to drain some brew.
I cannot believe it.
We are, yeah. Okay.
What is my purpose? What do I do?
All you got to do is close your eyes. We're going to go to the bar. We're going to go to the cave. All my buddies are over there.
Should I put my hand on my spot?
No, don't put. Wipe that stuff off your head, too.
Yes,
I don't want my friends to see that stuff, huh? All right?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to transform to a bar. I'm going to snap my fingers now.
Right.
You got that?
Right.
And then we're going to transform to a bar. Okay?
Good.
Close your eyes.
Okay.
All right?
Yes.
Ready? One, two, three.
Hey, Gus, five pitchers over here. Come on, another round.
All right, okay.
Hey, get on it.
You don't need 19, man. Don't worry about it, all right? This place is cool. Hey, Gus, how you doing?
Hey, how you doing, Craig?
Hey, two beers for me and my partner.
Can I see your ID, Sabu?
Well, I sure do. I'm old enough.
Hey, he's cool. He's a friend of mine. Come on, just give him a beer.
I fought in the war.
Yeah.
There you go.
Hey, only go around once in life, eh? Who do you take? I take the Bears this week. What do you think of
Kansas City by 23.
Ah, forget
Come
it.
Come on,
Kansas
you can't
City.
Be.
The Bears are coming up this year.
The Bears are a joke.
Pearson!
Hey!
Hey, Dennis, how you doing?
Tahia!
Tahia!
Hey, man.
Hey, how you doing?
How's
Dennis?
It going?
Good.
Hey, who's the tall head, Craig?
Hey, this is Beulah. This is Dennis Pearson.
Beulah, huh?
Hello, Dennis. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Beulah. He looks like an Indian, Craig.
Yeah, he is.
Oh, wow. Hey, Gus, give me a beer, will ya?
I'll see some ID.
Come on, Gus. I'm in here every night, huh?
Come on, ID.
Gus, all right, here, look.
What is this? This is a Xerox copy.
Come on, Gus, I don't want to carry the original around. I could lose it.
Come on, Gus,
lighten up.
Good, all right. Hey, Craig, did you go down to McD's before?
No, what's happening?
Hey, what happened? The betas, they bullwhipped their pledges, man. They threw them in there naked in the restaurant.
Oh,
Campus cops came and everything. It was great.
I'll only go there a little later.
All right, man, should be good.
Hey, you come up Wisconsin this weekend with me?
No, I can't, man. I'm going to Terre Haute.
What's happening in Terre Haute?
Oh, they're having a purple passion party. Last year they had one. They burned down the whole campus, man.
Oh, terrific.
It's unbelievable. Hey, Buell, you want to go?
I don't think I can make it, no. Thank you.
Oh, okay, Todd. See ya.
Okay, see ya, Dennis. Okay. Hey, that's Dennis Pearson. He's a cool guy.
He's a neat guy.
Yeah,
He's a neato.
Well, I like going down to Terre Haute. I'm going to Wisconsin. Hey, Gus.
Yeah.
Have you been in Wisconsin?
Yeah, a couple times.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it?
Yeah,
I've never been there.
Hey, Sky! Hey! Hey, Boomer!
Hey!
Boomer!
Hey, kissing the aluminum doors lately?
Hey,
how you doing? Give me a brew, Gus. Hey, Donna! Donna, where's Donna? Give Donna a wall banger, will you?
Yeah.
Okay, come on.
Oh, Donna, Boomer, this is my friend Buell here.
Nice to meet you.
Hey, Razor Face, how you doing?
Nice to meet you, Mr. Boomer.
Hey, you want some beef jerky?
Well, no, thank you. Thank you very much.
Come on, take a bite.
I cannot eat it. I cannot eat
that. He can't eat it because he's an Indian, you see. He can't eat beef jerky.
You can't eat beef jerky. This is good for you. Take some. Come on.
I'm sorry I cannot eat beef in my country where
this
I come from.
This guy's insulting. I cannot eat beef jerky.
Come
on. Friend of yours, Baker? I'm offering something. Don't want it? What?
Boomer, come on. Lighten up, man.
No, I really cannot. I better not.
He's a strange guy.
Okay, come on.
I got to take a whiz. Wait a minute. Watch my old lady, will you?
Okay, see you later.
Say like so. You're really from India.
Yes, indeed I am. I'm from India.
India's like a really large, big country. Yeah.
Right. Very, very, very spacious in its beauty and deep in its knowledge. Yes.
Oh, yeah. I had a girlfriend once, you know, she had like one of, you know how Indian girls wear those things in their forehead?
Or ladybug, yeah.
Yeah, she had one like drilled into her head, you know, and then after a while like a scab forms and it falls off and everything.
Falls off on the floor.
Yeah. Why don't like the men have those?
The men do have it. It's just in the back of the head and the hair grow over. May I say something? I don't want to be rude. Or anyone.
Oh no, go ahead.
Your eyes they remind me of the pools at the Taj Mahal.
Really? You've seen those?
Oh, I've sat as a boy. I used to sit at night and wash your eyes. And may I say to you that your eyes are very beautiful. Very beautiful. And your hair to me. May I say what your hair? Your hair falls.
Say it, yeah.
Your hair falls like the leaves during a monsoon. And as a no, don't laugh. It's true. Excuse me. I'm not trying to be rude. What I'm telling to you is true. How I feel in
my
heart.
You're cute. You know, you're really cute too.
I try to be cute.
What's
I try
going,
to be
what's,
cute.
What's going on?
I'm just talking to
Hello,
Bula.
Hello, woman. Nice to see you again.
What are you talking about? You know we're Lavalier.
Yeah, we are like
she's
Lavalier.
My old lady. What are you talking to? That's this guy, Greg, hey. Your friend. He's a
Boomer.
Jerk.
Man. Lighten up, Boomer. Come on,
beef
I'm
jerk.
Just speaking with your girl here. I'm not making.
No, I don't like your shoes. You know that?
I beg your pardon.
I don't like your shoes.
Hey, come on, lighten up, huh?
Those are. I'm not wearing shoes.
That's what I don't like. I don't like your feet because they're not shoes. You know what I mean? And they smell.
Come on.
I said they smell.
Well, I like the way your feet smell.
Oh, I don't like the way my feet smell.
I like the way your feet smell.
My feet smell worse than you. You saying your feet smell better than mine?
No, I say I like your
feet. You say they smell worse. Is that what you're saying?
I did not mean to smell them.
Come on, lighten
you're
up.
Asking for it, pal. You're asking for it.
Smell my feet.
Come on.
He's starting it. He's starting it.
Watch yourself.
Look at that. You see that? He just bumped into me.
Hey,
come on. What are you bumping into me for?
Boomer, please. I don't bump you.
What are you looking at me like that for? What are you looking at?
I gaze up on your head.
Okay, come on, Raisin Face. You take the first punch. Come on.
Call me Bueller.
Come on, towel head. Let's go. Put him up.
Please don't.
You're going to get duped.
Don't touch me, please.
Take the first punch. Go on, right here. Here's my chin.
I don't want to take a punch.
All right, I'll take it. Here.
Oh, my goodness. Come on. Boomer. Hey, Boomer.
Come on. Come on.
Oh, please. Come on, Boomer.
What are you telling her? Just watch it, man. My old lady.
Hey, come on. Hey, let's
Hey, come on, Boomer.
What are you looking at?
Hey, come on. Calm down, Boomer.
Yeah, he's a tough guy.
Oh, my
God. Right. You okay there?
My legs are my Gita.
You all right, Gita?
Here,
let me get you another beer. Hey, that was all right, you know? For a non-violent guy, you surely got whipped pretty good there.
I don't feel so good, Gus.
Hey, there's Tony's out in the parking lot. Come on, let's wail on him.
Tony's in the parking lot. Yeah, come on.
Yeah. Come on, let's go. Come on.
I better not go.
Come on, let's go.
I've got to see my wife, Peter.
All right,
Peter.
Hello once again, this is George Flack, and today our guest is a well-known entrepreneur and land developer, Mr. Donald Corleone.
Hello.
Mr. Corleone, how are you? Nice to meet you.
Very good to see you. Thank you.
You know, it's always been fascinating to me how a man of your stature and your build, as it were, could make so much money in such a short amount of time. It doesn't look to me like you've done much work in your day.
No, I didn't do too much work.
Mm-hmm. Well, how did you get started, Mr. Corleone?
Well, I wanted to be a senator, and I wanted to be a governor, mm-hmm. something, but there wasn't enough time, Michael. There mm-hmm. wasn't enough time.
So you did you went to school, or you?
No.
Well, exactly, how do you make money like that?
I mean, scare people.
You scare people?
That's right. They give me their money.
That is a funny concept. That is. You are putting me on, of course.
No, it's true.
That's what you do?
That's right.
Could you give me an example
of? Sure. What's this? I'll do this.
Well, this is curious. I wish you could all see this. He has a quarter of an orange, and he's taking the peel off it. Now, what is he doing? He's inserting it in his mouth. Now, he turned his head away. I can't see him. That is frightening. You do look a little frightening.
Give me your money.
Oh, well, I can't imagine giving you my money for something like that.
Well, it'll scare you.
It might scare my son or a grandson. But
doesn't scare you. Huh?
That scares me. What is that real?
That's right.
That's a real .38?
Uh-huh. Give me your money.
What do you mean, give me your money?
Give me your money.
Is this the way,
Give me your money.
I'm not going to give you my money. What are you talking about?
You're not going to give me your money?
Are you serious?
This is Harry Block with yet another of my 417 reasons why you should let us do your income tax. Reason number 408. If you are arrested for tax fraud, we will emphatically deny having anything to do with you so as not to prejudice your case. I'll be right back with additional reasons after this important message.
This is National Lampoon Radio.
I
North Ontario. It's safer than Alabama. It's safer than Ohio. Oh.
This is Harry Block with yet another of my 417 reasons why you should let us do your income tax. Reason 287. Because the cost of our services is itself tax deductible, we promise to overcharge you considerably and thus give you a much bigger deduction in 1974. I'll be right back with additional reasons after this important message.
I say, need to start a war, but you're worried about your intelligence? Come on down to the National Security Council. We'll make you a deal and you'll take home a war today. Good intelligence? Bad intelligence? No intelligence. It don't matter at the NSC. Can I help you, ma'am?
I would like to start a war against Latvia. I have a suspicious inkjet printout from a website on Latvian agriculture.
Gotta ask Dick Cheney.
Let her have it.
Just look at the invasions we got here in our factory showroom. We got covert ops in the Sudan. We got aerial sorties over Damascus. Folks, we're giving them away.
My wife and I would like to launch an amphibious assault on Barcelona, but all I have is a Xerox copy of my driver's license and a receipt from Taco Bell.
Gotta ask Dick Cheney.
Let her have it.
I say, no proof, no problem. I don't care where your intelligence comes from. It's good enough for us at the NSC. You can have the war you've always dreamed of with no evidence due at signing and no proof of malfeasance till January of 2004.
Come on down to the National Security Council. We'll be waiting for you.
Ladies and gentlemen, 15 years ago, a man arrived here in Los Angeles from the East claiming to be 2,000 years old. Since then, he has undergone a battery of tests at both the Menninger and Mayo clinics.
Hold the Mayo.
Tests which have established his claim to the satisfaction of our nation's leading geriatric specialists. He is seated, perhaps I should say, lounging with me here at poolside at the Beverly Hills Hotel.
Talking by the pool.
Sir, I wonder, sir.
Got on my suntan lotion.
Excuse me.
Yes, hello. Hello, how do you
sir.
Do? How are you? How's your face? Yes. How's your clothes? How's your tie?
Just fine,
yes, good.
And yourself?
Oh, the usual, peppy, zippy, tippy-top, rolling along, singing a song, talking to the girls, and just...
Sir?
My chest, I can't...
My God, this man is dying!
Someone get a gun!
This is Harry Block with yet another of my 417 reasons why you should let us do your income tax. Reason 177. To determine reason 177, take reason 116, add reason 149, and then subtract reason 96. Enter the result in reason 204. I'll be right back with additional reasons after this important message.
Mr. Brando, I understand you refused your Academy Award because of your sympathy with the Indians. Isn't that correct?
Yeah.
And most of your energies are now devoted to helping the Indians, aren't they?
Yeah. Yeah, that's the way I spend most of my time now.
Well, now, could you tell us why you believe in expending so much of your efforts in aiding the Indian cause?
Well, for one thing, because of the way the Indians have been treated in this country. I mean, you go out to the reservation and you see how they live, kind of like pigs. You know, I mean, because it's the only way they can live. It's the only way the government will let them live. That's one of the reasons. Of course, there are other reasons.
What are some of the other reasons, Mr. Brando?
Dark meat. Boy, I love that stuff.
Beg your pardon?
Dark meat. Oh, boy.
I'm sorry, Mr. Brando. Are you inferring that the...
Those Indian squaws, boy. They look like bunnies. Boy, you get one of them squaws and they'll get the shit out of you. You know what I tell them to do? I tell them to take these two fingers and cut the fingernails off and just stick them up my ass. And I tell them to fuck a pig and to eat its vomit. God, I love it.
A lone starship hurtles across a trackless void. A single human spark bulleting beyond the barriers of space and time. Yes, radio listeners, set your imagination for the year 2000. It's time to blast off into the incredible with Flash Raspo, Space Explorer. When we last left Flash, he and his sidekick, Dr. Narco, the intelligent thermos, had been captured by the robot Amazons from the planet Stinky Pinky. Now, as we listen, Flash stands before the throne of Clarina, Queen of Space.
Well, cut off my legs and call me Shorty. Who is this over here?
Oh, hello?
That sounds... Hello? I think I'm in the wrong room. I don't know who you are. What are you wearing that? What's that, a muumuu? Dear, come over here and sit on my lap. Tell me all your problems.
Oh, no, I think I better get out of here. Hello? Where's the door? Doorknob fell off.
Hey, man, that was a really funny show, man.
Oh, man, let's play back the tapes, man, and write it all down, okay, man?
All right, man.
Oh, it'll be...
Oh, police! It's the police, man. What are we gonna...
Oh, man.
Cheech and Chong, no, man, they're not here, are they?
They're not here, man, no.
What do you want Cheech and Chong for, man?
Stealing comedy material.
Oh, wow, man, they want us for stealing material.
Oh, no.
We gotta eat beer. I'm gonna eat the tape, man.
I'm gonna
take
the
microphone,
man. Oh,
here,
man.
Eat our record.
Oh, eat the microphone, man.
Oh, man, I can eat the microphone.
You've been listening to the National Lampoon Radio Hour.
You've been listening to the National Lampoon Radio Hour.
Honk, honk, why it's wobbles, the...